So I'm going to do a review and comparison on these two pistols. They are both the Wee Smith & Wesson M&P. Even though there are no trades, that they're the M&P, by the looks, that's the gun that they're trying to copy. And why do I have two boxes? Well, that's part of the review. As you will see, this is the gun that I originally wanted. And this is the full auto version of the M&P. And right away, when I received them, you just noticed that the boxes are different. And when you open up the box, this is what you get. The pistol, additional back straps in the flat dark earth, and these rave colored pink flamingo back straps, which I have no idea who is going to actually run those things. And I would suggest that we actually save themselves and us a couple of bucks, maybe a dollar, and not produce these things. If they made them in something actually useful, like black, or something crazy, if they want to go crazy, like zombie green, I would rock zombie green. I don't think I would rock pink. So this is the gun in full auto. And I had to look at it first to see what the difference was. And right away, what you see is this one has the full auto selector, whereas this one does not. And cosmetically, that is the only difference. So, why did I buy the semi-auto? The reason why I purchased this gun was that I needed a second mag. I mean, if you ever purchase a pistol, you're going to want at least two mags to run. And the thing was that the magazines were $22, and this gun was running for $80. So I thought that, that wasn't much of a difference between $22 for a magazine or just get another gun for $80, which is, 58 bucks for the gun, for the pistol, 22 for the magazine. So I went with this. It's very easy to take apart. There's a half moon here on the slide, and you just flip this up and the slide will come off. And I did this just to see, internally, I was looking for what the difference was. And this full auto selector moves this part of the gun here. I'm not sure what it's called, that piece. But within here, this will go up and down. Which this gun does not have. Disassemble this one. This piece just stays straight up. And actually, this happens to be, there were earlier generations of this M&P, and it was this problem, this part here that was giving, there was a widely occurring problem of the semi-auto gun going full auto. Full auto, and you didn't want it to go full auto, but it just went full auto. But apparently this piece here bent in so that it did not stop the slide. And actually, before I get these mixed up, because there is a difference also between the semi-auto and the full auto slide, and this is the difference. This part here is longer than, let me focus it again, you see the parts up in here, this one is slightly bigger, And this is the slide for the full auto pistol. And that is basically the difference between the two. You can see the finish here. It's slightly discolored, and that's because I greased up the slide. Otherwise, it's got this kind of powdery matte black finish, which, okay, my overall impression with the gun is that it's okay. I have some other WeTech guns that are much, that to me are much better, look much better, but, you know, cosmetically, it looks like a cool gun. If you look, if you're looking at it for the details and how well it's built, I would say it's just okay. Is it worth the money? This one is going for $80. If you want, I think for beginners, or if you want, you know, a decent starter gun, that's fine. This full auto version, I think, was like $109, $105, something like that. I bought both these guns from Evic, and at this point, they're marked down. So anyway, yeah, my overall rating is that they're just okay. The magazines are very good, and that's what makes this gun just okay. If the magazines were crappy, I would tell you, you know, that it's not so great a gun. Here's something that's kind of weird, and this happens with the my semi-auto one. The slide, when I cock it back, will stop. And, you know, I've greased this gun pretty well. I'm going to have to look to see where it gets held up. You know, if you do it like that, it won't get stuck. But if you, you know, release it slowly, it'll get stuck. And it shouldn't get stuck. Because, you know, here's the full auto one. Let's reassemble it. It doesn't get stuck either way. Just continues to slide. You know, it doesn't, right now, this is not, like, not making it perform, you know, not messing up its function. It still performs, but I just would like it that it slides. You know, there shouldn't be an obstruction. Another reason why I say this gun is just okay, I don't like the feeling of this trigger, and you know, there's no magazine. It feels cheap. I think it's plastic, polymer. You know. It just doesn't feel good, and eventually I'm probably gonna get an upgrade kit for this from overseas. I've seen some really good upgrade kits for this MMP, and actually the reason why I ended up going with this MMP is I had the intention of getting an upgrade kit. So anyway, it's an okay gun. They're your sights. A lot of people are complaining about them. And the reason is that, you know, they're supposed to be, like, glow-in-the-dark, but they're very, very dim. They don't really work. It's more like a cosmetic. So that side, there's no trademark at all. I wish they did, but, you know, that would bump up the price of the gun. The only thing that is trademarked is the Wii. There's no Smith & Wesson. You know, there is a 9mm up here. And supposedly this is a port where in the real steel version you would be able to see if there's a bullet in the chamber. But this doesn't function. If there's, like, for example, if there's a BB in the chamber, it's not like you can see the BB. So they both each came with this one came, the semi-automatic came with a manual. The fully automatic one did not come with a manual, which I thought was a little odd. But then again, when I flipped through the manual, it wasn't all that useful. It was kind of basic. Had to load the magazine with gas, had to load the magazine with BBs. Told you, like, the different names of the parts of the gun. It didn't tell you about disassembly, you know, some basic safety instructions for shooting, and that was about it. There's a blow-up part, the parts of the gun, and they did come with magazines. Each one came with a pretty good magazine. Supposedly they hold 22 BBs, if you can load them, you know, perfectly. I always get this weird thing where, you know, there's one missing somewhere or other, it doesn't stack totally perfectly. But these are very good magazines, so far. Like, I filled them up, there's no leaks. And, you know, something that I recommend, if you have a new magazine, before you put the BBs in, put a drop of silicone oil in here, and take that follower and just, like, rack it, you know, and let the oil spread, and, you know, it'll help with the feeding of the BBs. But anyway, yep, that's it. Like I said, okay guns, just okay. I'm gonna put, to dress it up, I'll dress it up a little bit and then I'll show you how they fire. Okay, so I'm gonna make it look a little more tactical. Just gonna do, put the slide on here. Fits right on the slide. Makes it look a little cooler. And this one is, I don't know, I guess it's a copy of the Surefire. I'm not sure which model, maybe the M6. But it is a China copy, it's not the real thing. But the light is pretty bright. So that's the, it's an LED. Oh, I'm sorry, not LED, but, and also a working laser. So, you know, bumps up the, tactical quotient. And if, you know, if you're gonna run anything, might as well make it tactical. And the good thing about the magazine is they fit really well. I do like that part. You know, there's no wobble basically. Once you get them in there, it's got a nice smooth sound to it. And, oh, let me go and show this. One of the cool things about this gun is that you can change the grips. They did come with three tan grips and three pink flamingo grips. But it's very easy to change, and they do make a noticeable difference. So, according to your hand size, you know, you can put the one that you like that fits best with your palm grip. So it's very easy. This plastic thing down here, turn it a quarter of a turn, pull it out, and just as an example, you just, you know, stick your fingernail up in there, pull it out like this, comes off easy. And just as an example, let's stick this pink flamingo one in there. It's got this rubber tab. They all have a rubber tab to fit in there. So, let's just get it on there. And this is the biggest version. Put it in. How did I have it? A quarter turn again. Just turn it. And there it is. It's locked in place. This gives you a very big grip. Personally, I don't like it. It's a little too big for my hand here. But for people with larger hands, you know, this is nice too, because it kind of makes a nice curve here. And pocket. Okay. Again, taking the mag out. Let's do that again. Switch it for tan. Switch it back to the one I like, which is the smallest one. Let's do the notch. The notch. It's only a quarter turn, and there you go. And I'm gonna show you how it shoots. BB in the chamber. got a nice quick kick. Very loud. And this is if you flip it up, then it's like a safety. So let's flip it down. Nice fast return. And when the magazine is empty, it does lock back. Empty. Down to the last bullet, BB, we're up again, and there you go. And just to show that the magazines are, you know, the same ones, I just took this one out of the semi-auto one because I didn't finish the gas on the BBs, so I just put it back into, this is the full auto. Water. More BBs.